Hi there, Mouseketeers. Welcome to the Disneyland Beat, where our toes tap to a Disneyland drum.
And we always whistle while we work.
Another month has come and gone, and the parks are still closed.
We sure miss Disneyland.
In this newscast, we'll take a look at what's been going on with the Disney parks and how COVID has been affecting things.
We check in on cast members, and of course, we talk about Shanghai Disneyland.
We'll take a look at what construction is happening.
We look at the content Disney Plus and Disney Parks has been putting out.
And of course, we discuss the status of the Disney parks and theme parks around the country and when they might open again.
Like, subscribe, and stick around.
Well, hi there, folks.
We sure hope this finds everybody in good spirits.
And coming together in this crisis.
Well, the internet has been providing a lot of great Disney Park at-home material to keep us all entertained this past month.
There have been a ton of homemade Disney rides worth checking out.
A retirement home in Utah recreated Disneyland in their rooms.
And another fan recreated most of Disneyland out of Legos.
We dropped two different videos that showcase over 22 different homemade Disney attractions that some amazing Disney fans recreated at home for all of us to enjoy.
And we put on our own production of our favorite attraction, Disneyland's Fantasmic, in our backyard. We hope you check out the link. We had a blast putting it together.
Disney has continued to create the Olaf from Home shorts, which we love. They're cute and they're charming and now moving.
Go check out the new song, I Am With You, written by the incredible composing team that brought you the music from Frozen. It hits you hard, right in the feels. It's quite beautiful.
Yes, we are so impressed with that musical team.
Speaking of Frozen, though, Disney has started to permanently close some Broadway shows, like Frozen, a show that probably didn't have the longevity of Lion King, but one that definitely should have seen a longer run.
It's not a good sign for the shows currently running on Broadway. Those shows cost so much money to produce that even once they reopen, social distancing seating might not be profitable enough to make it worthwhile.
Disney did have a second sing-along from home online and quickly dropped that on Disney Plus, which we appreciated. Disney Plus also dropped the dramatic closer to the Clone Wars series, which we loved.
In our opinion, Ahsoka Tano is really one of the Star Wars universe's best and most complex characters. We sure hope to see her in the second season of The Mandalorian.
However, we did find it interesting that with the popularity of Disney Plus, they have started to shutter or consolidate some of their cable channels.
The Disney Channel and Disney XD have closed shop in certain countries and regions, none of which are the USA. It's not a worry if you ask me anyways, they're just readjusting their digital platforms.
Disney parks have been releasing fun ride-throughs and shows. The extremely well-filmed Magical Dreams fireworks show and the spooktacular Not-So-Haunted Halloween from Walt Disney World was amazing. And the fun fact ride-throughs, they're a nice source of fun.
They have also been releasing almost every recipe in the park, spawning a huge amount of YouTube videos of people making the park treats and dishes at home.
They are a lot of fun. Of course, if you didn't know, you can always go to City Hall at Disneyland and get the recipe to almost anything in the parks.
City Hall is a pretty cool place. If you've never been, it's worth a visit, folks.
Overall, it's a pretty cool move by Disney Parks, though.
Yes, indeed.
Disney cast members are again showing they are inspirational in their devotion to their craft.
It's a long road and there are so many out of work. More than anything, we wish the parks would reopen so the cast members can get back to doing what they love and get their incomes back. But we really still want everyone to be safe.
A recent article in the Wall Street Journal interviewed a number of cast members who played different roles, and it was heartwarming.
In the interviews, cast members detailed the intensive workout routine that it takes to maintain the ability to be good friends with characters like Cinderella, Timon, and Vampirina.
It sounds like an impressive amount of work to be a character, not least of all, maintaining your silhouette.
But lots of cast members have been keeping their skills fresh, from doing character makeup at home to just watching lots of Disney Plus. Not to enjoy it, but to study and to keep in touch with the characters and the parks.
Cast members, we think you are the best and we wish you the best in these crazy times.
Mostly, the only folks actually inside the parks have been people deemed essential workers.
So, of course, there are security services.
Animal caretakers and veterinarians are still at work at Animal Kingdom.
And you can't lock the doors on the outdoor sections of the park, so basic park maintenance and cleaning is continuing.
There was and is an enormous amount of food that had to be dealt with. We thought it was great that Disneyland donated so much food to local food banks.
But that work actually still continues at a trickle as kitchens and freezers get cleaned.
Construction work at the parks has not changed status too much from our last video.
Most of the construction sites have been stopped and workers sent home. However, construction workers deemed to be essential by California standards are allowed to work.
So, both Avengers Campus and Mickey and Minnie's Runaway Railway have continued this minimal construction during the crisis.
It has been explained to us that this means to include construction that was already started and that if not allowed to continue would create a dangerous situation or damage.
It is our understanding that electrical runs are being completed, which should speed things up when the parks return to full construction.
It is somehow comforting to know that even though it's going at a snail's pace, Disney park construction continues.
So now we move on to when and how the parks might open, which is really difficult to predict. There are two major factors to consider, one being all the health concerns and the other is politics. So we will try to keep that in mind as we proceed.
Shanghai Disneyland is open. They opened this past Monday the 11th and just had their first seemingly successful week.
Orlando Mayor Buddy Dyer said just a couple of days ago that he hoped to see the parks open in June. But don't get excited, Disney World hotels are not booking until July.
On May 15th, Disney World submitted an opening plan that has no set dates and got approved by Florida legislature.
So between that and Shanghai Disneyland, we know a bit about what it's going to look like when the parks open.
There will be reservations required and reduced park attendance.
Social distancing will be the norm, and temperature and health screenings will be added to security checks.
There will be hand sanitizer and hand washing stations everywhere, as well as plastic dividers and face shields at cast member stations. Everybody, and that includes the cast members and the guests, are expected to wear masks.
Oh, and by the way, the mask goes over your nose, folks.
And there are no shows or fireworks to keep crowds low, and character greetings are done at a distance.
All transactions are cashless and done via phone or Magic Band, something like that.
Merchandise cannot be touched unless you are going to purchase it.
The additional element we expect to see more of, and we have not heard too much about, is keeping records for contact tracing. We think Disney will indeed have to be able to keep a record of every attraction you go on. So that means everything's going to have a fast pass or a reservation. We don't know that.
We work at a college, and as they begin to reopen, they are requiring health screening check-ins before and after each class and activity on every campus visit for contact tracing purposes. It's a lot of paperwork.
How many of you would be willing to put up with that to get into the parks?
We don't think it sounds that bad, especially the low crowd part, and we encourage everybody to be willing to embrace these precautions to keep each other safe.
So what's happening now in the theme park world? What's open already? We'll talk about that.
Disney Springs in Orlando and Mrs. Knott's Kitchen at Knott's Berry Farm and Universal City Walk in Hollywood have started to open retail and restaurants for takeout, and we expect that to expand over the next couple of weeks.
But that really isn't that big a news, folks. The restaurants have been open for takeout the entire shutdown in most places.
And that, folks, brings us to the million-dollar question we are getting the most often, which is, when is Disneyland itself going to open?
And the truth is, we don't know. And nobody does. There's new news coming out almost every day, but once you get through the headline, you end up where you began.
Here is what we do know.
Disney has definitely extended its hotel reservation dates for Disneyland and Walt Disney World until July.
However, in California, Governor Newsom has extended lockdown protocols that look likely to make park opening impossible before mid-August at the earliest.
So we hate to say it, but in California especially, we're going to be really lucky to have a summer in the bigger parks at all this year. And if smaller parks do open, they are going to be impacted.
Cedar Fair shockingly announced they might be keeping many of their more seasonal parks closed until spring of 2021. Wow.
And now it has been confirmed that Universal Studios Hollywood has begun construction of its Halloween mazes. Now that says a lot. That's kind of big. It's not, I guess, unexpected, but that construction does not usually start until late August for a mid-September opening for Halloween. And Disney's actually been talking a lot about halfway to Halloween a lot recently, so I don't know why they're talking about that so much.
As we mentioned, they have an approved opening plan, as does SeaWorld and Legoland in San Diego, for that matter.
But it still may yet be a while before they're ready to go for it.
It looks like the major players, the corporations with multiple parks like Disney, Universal, Six Flags, Legoland, SeaWorld, and Cedar Fair will be taking a more cautious route. And this makes sense. They have more guests, they're under greater scrutiny, and they have more to lose.
Smaller parks around the country, depending on which state, are planning to open up, many by June.
And due to the political aspect of this debate, it might actually depend on what state the park is in.
Attractions have already opened in some places around the country, like Branson, Missouri, and Pigeon Forge, Tennessee, although the larger parks like Dollywood's not open yet, but the Big Smoky Mountain Wheel is.
Silverwood, a family theme and water park in Idaho, opens May 27th with a similar reservation and social distancing guidelines to Disney's plans, much of which are new to this park, but no attraction reservations and masks are optional.
We will also be looking towards the Wisconsin Dells over the next couple weeks. It's a water park hotspot and many are planning to open before June. Kind of surprised us too.
One of the biggest in the Dells, Mount Olympus, is opening under the current plan of only making the parks available to hotel guests, which will keep the capacity of the parks under 50%.
Some of the rules we thought were interesting are that elevators are for luggage only, not for people, and that even these smaller parks are figuring out ways to make all their purchases via wristband, and social distancing barriers are in place, that kind of thing.
We don't see masks being a thing at a water park, and my nose is always a little runny around that much chlorine.
We did find that the CDC did state that due to the high bromine and chlorine levels, that the water itself is fairly safe.
But the truth is, it's definitely a decided risk to go to a park at this point. It's a choice you will have to make.
The debate isn't over, and time will tell, and I think like most people, we just really hope the best for everyone. We want everyone to be healthy, and we want people's businesses to not go under both of those things.
With the varying approaches of the parks, we think it's kind of a difficult choice.
Disney has shown us that it can be done. At least a week in, it can be done. But it needs to be done as safely as possible. And we like a company like Disney that we can trust to err on the side of caution to a certain extent, and they at least have the resources and the ability to do it.
Shanghai Disneyland is open and has had a fairly successful week.
But we hope America is ready as well. We think a lot of this is up to us and how respectful and patient that we can be as an American public.
And just the act of wearing or not wearing a mask has become a political act as the country divides further on how we should be dealing with the COVID pandemic.
People are flipping out and attacking state capitals as well as local Red Lobsters. They're taking it into their own hands. The country is very divided on how we should be responding to this pandemic.
We go back and forth on when that park should open personally, but we do think that having something like Disneyland open and functioning in the world is a positive thing. That means we have a world where we are allowed to have fun.
But things aren't so bad that people are not still able to enjoy themselves.
Having the parks closed, even if completely justified and necessary, is so sad. A symbol of the joy of society, of being human, is dimmed.
We leave our homes and we go to a place like Disneyland to have shared experiences. So that's the best part about the parks. It's sharing them with someone else.
For us, it's about being around people as passionate about Disney parks as we are.
And the parks are designed to create these communal shared experiences.
And now they're having to try and take the shared part out of the show. We think that's very sad.
We're very grateful Disney, and especially the Disney fans, are creating shared experiences online while the parks are closed. And just to put it out there, we do think the parks needed to close.
We look forward to the celebration we get to have together when we put this pandemic behind us.
We are going to party down, people.
For now, we have to find joy in other ways, in those close to us, in ourselves.
Well, that's about it for now.
We are so appreciative to everybody who is pumping positivity and love out into the multiverse.
And we are grateful for the fantastic folks we've gotten to meet through doing these videos. Thanks for the support and awesome comments.
Please check out our recent video on the things we miss about Disneyland. And like and subscribe, please.
Be considerate to each other, folks.
Please be respectful to the medical and essential workers who are saving lives and keeping everybody going during these stressful times. And thank you.
And if you are in a position to do so, please donate to the food banks. We will put a link in the description and on the screen.
See you real soon, Mouseketeers.
See you real soon.